What's good YouTube? Reese Rockman, aka rockhardfitness, coming at you with episode 2 of Brittany's fat loss diet journey thingamajig. So in today's video, guys, we're actually going to take you through a full day of eating for my baby sister. Right, so this is going to be everything she eats, everything she puts in her mouth. I will film, we'll get it on camera. We're also going to tell you why she eats the food that she does, and does she eat certain foods for fat loss, does she eat certain foods to make her feel fuller, does she eat certain things just because she wants to? This is what we'll find out today. So if you guys are struggling with meal ideas, this is literally the girl to go to, because Brittany has a very, very chef mindset behind her meals. Brittany's food looks good, it tastes good, and again, it's healthy, it's nutritionally good for you. So without further ado, we're gonna get into the first meal, which is
toasted chicken wraps with mozzarella with a basil pesto, paprika, and yogurt sauce on the side to dip the wraps in.
And how long does that take you to make?
15 to 20 minutes max.
Okay, now you see, for me that's too long, but anyway, let's go check out what she's eating. Alrighty, so this is Brittany's meal one, which is what again?
It's toasted chicken wraps with a basil pesto yogurt dip with garlic and seasoning in.
Okay, cool. So I had my meal at about 11. It's now 10 past 12. So what time did you stop eating last night?
Just before 7 p.m.
Okay, so she started eating, stopped eating just before 7. It's now 10 past 12. So that's actually 17 hours of fasting. So that's literally the definition of intermittent fasting, because the only other, what else have you had today?
Just a cup of black coffee after I walked, and then some water.
So she's only had black coffee and water, which has kept her in a fasted state. And unlike myself, like I said, I don't follow traditional intermittent fasting. I have a mocha the first thing I wake up, which has hot chocolate and milk in. So my fast has been broken the minute that touches my lips. But she literally follows it verbatim. But it's not because she follows intermittent fasting, it's just how her specific day is going.
Yeah.
Other days she might not, yeah. Some days she might. It's again all up to her own personal choice. But that's meal one for her. That looks pretty good. So what are you gonna eat next?
I'm gonna have a protein shake after we train.
Cool, so we're gonna go train, and then she's gonna have that protein shake, and then we'll bring you guys along with it.
Alrighty guys, so that's the pool session done. Now I'm gonna make the post-workout shake I told you about previously. It's gonna have a serving of apple and banana. The reason why I use both these fruit is for different vitamins and minerals. Then it's gonna have some milk for extra protein and to make the shake creamier. And then I'm gonna put in some oats for fiber, and apparently it's very good for heart health. And then in addition to that, I'm gonna have some whey, which is for extra protein. And yeah, that's the shake. And then. Ladies and gents, we are now by the final meal, which is a tuna noodle salad. So what I like to do is I like to pre-cook my macaroni, and I'm going to have about 100 grams of this. And then to my fat content for the day, I'm going to have the trim mayonnaise and some basil pesto. And for crunch, I normally like to add the different color peppers and some spring onion. And then just for some flavor, some sweet chili sauce. And then I'm having 50 grams of tuna, because my first meals chicken breast weighed more than expected, so I had to count for that. And we're very late with the editing for this specific meal, so we're just gonna whip back into the last meal's final product in 3, 2, 1. And there we have it, guys, the last meal of the day, which is tuna noodle salad. This meal took me a lot less time compared to my other meals, as I only had to cut the peppers and just assemble everything into the bowl. And you can see there's a lot of color going on here. The peppers are really good for nutrients, that's why I add them. And with that, it is done. Let me eat my food.
Nom, nom, nom. Alright, ladies and gents, so that's Brittany's final meal of the evening. I'll put all of her macros up here. There we go. And what we'll do now is we're going to just go into a little bit of an update, because this video will go out on a Monday. So it'll be the start of week two. So I just want to get her thoughts on how week one went. We're going to go through our averages, if we're going to make any changes, and just see, you know, how good is the diet slash weight loss slash change in lifestyle. Jesus, I don't know, man. All right, ladies and gents. Well, in all reality, probably just ladies. So Brittany's finished her first week of dieting. We're on a Sunday. So we're going to go over basically her weekly check-in, right? So that's basically going to be going over her macros, how much weight she lost or gained, and also how she felt throughout this whole week. So first thing I want to ask is, Britt, how was this first week of dieting?
It wasn't bad as I thought it was going to be. Initially, I was very apprehensive about starting again because of the determination and being the discipline. But the first week wasn't as bad as I thought it was. I think the logging of macros became a lot easier as I got deep into the week, and just trying to see which foods like make me fuller and which don't, and just experimenting. And I think I did pretty well for the first week.
Yeah, so actually leading into that, so Brittany actually lost a total of 1.41 kgs. Yeah, so 1.41 kgs, that's about 3 and a bit pounds. Britt, how were you feeling in terms of food-wise? How did your specific foods make you feel full? Did you feel hungry on these macros?
The first few days, I could, like, near the end of the night, I could feel, okay, the hunger is setting in, even after I had, like, my 3 set meals. But I didn't think too much about it, because I feel like if I'd eaten something off my macros, then I would have felt guilty anyway. So, but after a while, once I started experimenting with different foods and just swapping my specific meals at different times, it actually ended up working to my benefit instead of not working to my benefit.
Yeah, so remember, making sure that you eat foods that taste good, but also they're quite voluminous, I think that's a word. So, for example, 300 grams of vegetables is going to fill you up a lot more than 300 grams of rice, but the vegetables are going to have fiber, nutrients, micronutrients, and pretty much barely any carbs. The vegetables that we like to eat, it's about 5 grams of carbs per 100 grams, so I mean, in 300 grams of vegetables, that's 15 grams of carbs, probably around 8 grams of fiber. And if you compare that to something like rice, well, 300 grams of rice, you're going to get about 80 grams of carbs. So imagine taking all those vegetables, mixing it with maybe 100 grams of rice, and you'll get the same volume. There'll be a lot of different colors, you'll get a lot of fiber in there as well, and it'll keep you fuller for longer. At the start of the week, I did notice Brittany was having more of the denser portions of food. As in, she really enjoys wraps, but she'd be having maybe 2 or 3 at a time instead of just 1 or 2. Right, but now, I mean, today, for example, she was like, Reese, these are what I have for the day, and it's a lot of food. And I was like, yeah, it's a lot of food, which means you won't get hungry. Mm-hmm. Right, so again, for the next week of diet, week two, we're not changing anything. So the macros will stay at 140 protein, 230 carb, and 50 grams of fat. And also, we're gonna keep the step count at 10,000 steps. So without further ado, ladies and gents, that is the video. Again, if you missed episode 1 of the series, then click over here. I'll put it up on the cards. Please don't forget to put the D in subscribe. Hit that like video just to show Brittany some support for her exam tomorrow. And don't forget, we will be putting out another one of these videos next week. And I will be putting out 1 or 2 more videos within this week as well. Reese Rockman, aka Rock Hard Fitness, and
Brittany Lee Rockman
Fitness. Signing out, we'll check you guys in the next video. Bye.